Hello viewers, I'm Tarang Kumar Gondwal, Assistant Professor in St. Andrew's Institute of Technology and Management. The following video is prepared as per the syllabus and course outline of Maharishi Dayanand University. However, there are mostly general topics which cover the working and theoretical aspects of civil engineering. For best understanding and conceptualizing clearly, please do not skip the video and watch till end. At the end of the video and each topic and each section, we will be discussing about the related important questions, feasibility and working application. Let's start the video. Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. We'll continue with design of concrete structures first. We discussed about modular ratio and transformed area in the previous class. So today we'll start with a fresh new topic, which is related to the earlier told topics, that is design of singly reinforced rectangular beam using WSM, that is working stress method. So while designing a rectangular beam, the first step to be considered is we have to determine the depth of neutral axis. So neutral axes are of two types. One is actual neutral axis and other is critical neutral axis that we learn in this topic only. So first we'll find actual depth of neutral axis. Let us assume this is our concrete section. This is the cross section of concrete. Yeah, here. So actually there is a mistake in it. I'll mark it. Small d is from here till here, from top to the bottom reinforcement. This is capital D, total depth of the section. This is small d, which is known as effective depth of section. This is B, breadth of section. This is XA, depth of neutral axis, that is actual neutral axis. This is half of XA, XA by 2. And this is, this overall is D, and so this comes out to be D minus XA. And this is M, modular ratio, into AST, area of steel. These three are steels. And this is the stress profile of the section, where this shows stress in concrete under bending compression, sigma CBC. And this is stress in steel under tension divided by modular ratio, sigma ST by M. This is the general case. So if we equate moments about neutral axis, B multiplied by XA, B multiplied by this XA, multiplied by XA by 2 is equal to MAST multiplied by D minus XA. So these are equating and multiplying moments. By transposing and simplifying, we get BXA square by 2 is equal to MAST into D minus XA, from which we can calculate that actual depth of neutral axis depends on area of steel. So area of steel matters when we have to calculate depth of actual neutral axis. Now coming to the critical neutral axis. So again, this is capital D, overall depth of our section. This is small d, effective depth of section. B, breadth of section. Again, MAST. Now this time, let us assume XC, critical neutral axis. So this comes out to be D minus XC. And in stress profile, we can see this now turns out to be XC, this much distance. This is again sigma CBC. This is D minus XC, and this lower profile is sigma ST by M. Critical depth is defined as the depth at which maximum permissible stress in concrete and steel are obtained at the same time. Jab concrete aur steel mein bil ek same time pe, jo ek worst case bola jata hai, jab maximum stresses attain kar le, to wo ek critical neutral axis wali state pe pahunch jata hai. So if we use the property of similar triangles, sigma CBC by XC. This sigma CBC upon XC is equals to sigma ST by M. This sigma ST by M and divided by D minus XC. This D minus XC. So this upon this is equal to this upon this. This is done by using property of similar triangle. And by simplifying it, we get this expression. Transposing everything on the right hand side and keeping XC on the left hand side, we get this. And it can also be defined as XC is equals to KD. This whole expression 1 upon 1 plus sigma ST by M sigma CBC can be replaced by K, where K is coefficient of neutral axis given by this expression as we discussed. So different type of beam sections. When we compare the values of sigma, XA and XC, actual neutral axis and critical neutral axis. So if the value of actual neutral axis is equal to critical neutral axis, then sigma dash CBC is equals to sigma CBC and sigma dash ST is equals to sigma ST. So sigma dash means actual and sigma means permissible. So this gives a balanced section. If XA is less than XC, which gives sigma ST is equal to sigma ST, but sigma dash CBC comes out to be less than sigma CBC, which means under reinforced section. And if XA, that is actual neutral axis, is greater than critical neutral axis, then sigma dash CBC is equals to sigma CBC, but sigma dash ST is less than sigma ST, which means a over reinforced section. Next point to be calculated is moment of resistance. So the maximum value of bending moment that a beam can resist safely is known as moment of resistance. So again, this is D, this is B, this is XA, and this is its stress profile with same values XA. And if we find the centroid, we as we know from our elementary education that this centroid lies at XA by 3 from this end. And the value of C, that is compression, because concrete, this section is concrete, concrete takes compression and there is no reinforcement. So it comes out to be sigma CBC plus 0 divided by 2 multiplied by BXA. So moment of resistance on compression side, which is given by C into Z, and Z is known as lever arm. This value is known as lever arm. So C is half sigma CBC multiplied by BXA into Z, which is lever arm given by D minus XA by 3. This total was from here till here was D, and we have to find the value of this. So this comes out to be total is D minus XA by 3. So this gives the value of Z. Same is moment of resistance for tension side, which is given by T multiplied by Z, and the value of T is sigma ST multiplied by AST, area of steel into stress in steel under tension, again multiplied by D minus XA by 3. Same like above case. So again, for this section, for under reinforced section, value of actual neutral axis is less than value of critical neutral axis, which gives the failure of beam due to failure of steel. It is known as ductile failure. So whenever the beam fails in this case, when X is less than XC, failure of beam is known as ductile failure. Kyunki pehle जो रीइंफोर्समेंट है वो कोलैप्स करती है, वो पहले फेल करता है स्टील से पहले, कंक्रीट से पहले. नेक्स्ट इज द केस ऑफ ओवर रीइंफोर्स्ड सेक्शन व्हेन XA इज ग्रेटर देन XC. सो फेलियर ऑफ बीम ड्यू टू कंक्रीट फेलियर, व्हिच इज नोन एज ब्रिटल फेलियर, इट Here, concrete fails prior to steel. And when it is balanced section, that is given by this, where XA is equal to XC, D minus KD by 3, and where 1 minus K by 3 is equals to DJ, and J is lever arm coefficient. So guys, we'll discuss a numerical here. So a reinforced beam of size 350 mm by 600 mm is made up of M20 grade of concrete and reinforced with 420 mm dia bars of Fe415 steel. Calculate the cracking moment of beam and stresses due to applied moment of 55 kN. Take M value is equals to 13.33 and effective cover as 50 mm. So solution. First, we have to write the given data. Capital D is 600, B is 350. Reinforcement given is 4 bars of 20 mm dia. Characteristic strength of concrete, because it is M20 grade, so it is 20 MPa. Fy steel Fe415, so Fe4, so 415. And cover given out to be 50 mm. First step is finding the modulus of rupture. It is given by the formula 0.7 under root FCK. 0.7 under root 20. So this gives out to be 3.13 Newton per mm square. Step 2. Finding cracking moment, MCR. So MCR is FCR into I by Y. FCR we have found out from here. And I is BD cube by 12. And Y is D by 2. So we find the value as 65.730 kN. This is the value of cracking moment. Step 3, we find cracking moment using transformed area method. It was untransformed area, and now we'll find cracking area, cracking moment using transformed area method. Transformed area we have learned in the previous lecture. So the formula is again FCR multiplied by IT divided by YT, where IT moment of inertia of transformed area and YT is distance of internal tension fiber from neutral axis. Area of steel is given by 4 into pi by 4 into 20 square. So this gives out to be 1256.64 mm square. Area of transformed section is given by area of concrete plus transformed area of steel. Area of concrete is given by AG minus AST, that is gross area minus area of steel, but plus transformed area of steel was M into AST. So by taking AST common, we come out to this expression, AG plus M minus 1 AST, where AG is gross area, so it is B into D, plus M's value is given 13.33 minus 1, and AST we have just found out here. So putting the values, we get area of transformed section as 225.5 multiplied by 10 to the power 3 mm square. So this is our section. M minus 1 AST is this value. YS, Y that is neutral axis, is equal to critical neutral axis. And YT is this value. Now the depth of neutral axis, AT multiplied by Y is equals to BD into D by 2. Transformed area into Y is equals to gross area into half of total depth plus M minus 1 AST into D, where D is effective depth. So total depth is 600 minus 50 as it was given in the question. So it comes out to be 550 mm. Y is equals to YC is equals to 317.17 mm. So we can find this value from here. So this is ys and this is yt. It is d minus the value of yc, which comes out to be this, and yt is this plus effective cover. So here we can see this is yt and this is ys. So this whole is d, small d minus y gives the value of ys, and if we add 50 to ys, it gives yt. So this is what we have done here. These are the two values. Now the moment of inertia of transformed section, that is it. So for the upper section, it is byc cube by 3. Byc cube divided by 3. For midsection, byt cube by 3. Byt cube by 3. And for steel section, it is m minus 1 ast ys square. So this is m minus 1 ast multiplied by ys square. So putting all the values, b is 350, yc we have found out, yt again we have found out here, m we know it is given in the question, ast we have found out, and ys square we have also found out. So transformed moment of inertia is 7201.9 into 10 raised to the power 6 mm to the power 4. Now moment of cracking resistance is given by FCR. As we did it in the formula, we just have to now put the values here. FCR into IT upon YT. So FCR we found out, IT we have just found out, and YT we found out as well. So this comes out to be 79.7 kilonewton meter. Now the cracking moment of resistance for gross area is 65.73 kilonewton meter, and for transformed area it is 79.7 kilonewton meter. So now the value of stress due to applied moment of 55 kilonewton meter, because there is an additional moment applied which we'll be considering in step 4, and 55, as we can see, is less than MCR. Therefore the section is uncracked because the applied moment is less than the moment of cracking resistance which the section can resist. So the section remains uncracked. Next, maximum compressive stress in concrete is given by FC is equals to M by IT into YC. So M, we know this is given in the question, we have to use it, the external applied moment 55, YC we have found out, and IT we have also found out. So compressive stress in concrete is 2.42 Newton per mm square. So now we'll find maximum tensile stress in concrete, which is given by FT, again MT, M upon IT multiplied by YT. Here it was YC for concrete and it is YT for tension, that is steel. So putting all the values, we get it as 2.16 Newton per mm square. Now maximum tensile stress in steel, we have found out in concrete. Now we'll move to tensile stress in steel, which is given by FST is equals to M into FC by YS upon YC. So we know the value of everything we have found out. Putting those values here, M we have found out, FC we have found out, FC, yes. Here we found out FC, 2.42 here. So it comes out to be 23.68 Newton per mm square. So this is how we'll do this type of question. So we'll do one more numerical on the same topic, but this numerical is of different type. So here it goes. A rectangular beam of width 400 mm is to be designed for a live load of 300 kilonewton per meter, excluding the self weight, for simply supported span of 7.5 meter. Design beam for M20 and Fe415 and take effective cover as 50 mm. So step 1 is given data. effective span is given as 7.5 mm, which is 7500 mm. Small b is given as 400 mm. Live load 30 kN per meter. Characteristic strength of concrete 20 Newton per mm square. Yield stress of steel as 500 Newton per mm square. So next is step 2. For M20, the value of M is 13. This is from IS code, from IS 456. Sigma dash CBC is equals to sigma CBC is given as 7 Newton per mm square. That is permissible stress in concrete that we did in our first lecture. And sigma dash ST is equals to sigma ST is given by this. Dividing 20 by 3, we get it as almost 7, and dividing 500 by almost 1.8, we get 275 Newton per mm square. Sorry. So finding the value of KC, that is coefficient of neutral axis. So this was the formula that we learnt, 1 upon 1 plus sigma ST upon M sigma CBC. Putting all the values here, and it comes out to be 0.248. Now finding the value of J, that is coefficient of lever arm. So it is given by 1 minus KC upon 3. Putting all the values, we get J as 0.917. Moment of resistance represented by Q can also be found out using this formula given in IS code IS 456. Q is equals to 1 by 2 sigma CVC multiplied by KC multiplied by J. So putting all the values that we know, half, this is 7, this is 0.248, and this is 0.917. So it comes out to be 0.80. Next is design of singly reinforced beam. Finding cross-sectional dimension. So we have to find the D provided, which is 1 by 10 of effective length, and effective was 7500, and it comes out to be 750 mm. Finding self weight of beam, gamma multiplied by B multiplied by D. So this is this, its standard value is 25, and this is B is given, and capital D is also given. Sorry, capital D is not given. It is we have just found out from L effective value, that is 7500 divided by 10. So this is 750 mm or 0.75 meter. And so total weight comes out to be live load plus self weight. Live load is given as 30, and self weight we have just found out. So it comes out to be 37.5 kN per meter. Next is finding bending moment for simply supported beam. The formula is WL square upon 8. So W, we know, we have found out just from here. L effective length is 7.5 and 8. So this comes out to be 263.67 kN per meter. Now checking this values, D greater than BM divided by QB. So for bending moment, we have found out from here, this is the value, and Q, moment of resistance, is this, and this is B. So D greater than 907.7. D required comes out to be D plus effective cover. So this is D plus 50 effective cover, which was given in question. So this comes out to be 957.7 mm. D provided is less than D required. So this was the D required, which is 957.7 mm. And what we provided is this. D provided is 750 mm. So the section is not okay, because the requirement is more but provision is less. So we'll go for a second trial. Let us now assume D provided is 1000 mm. Now if new self weight is again gamma into B into D, 25 into 0.4 into D, because this time it is 1000 mm, so 1 meter, so it comes out to be 10 kN meter. And total weight is live load plus self weight, which comes out to be 40 kN per meter. Again, bending moment for simply supported beam is WL square by 8. So W is this time 40. L is again same, 7.5 and 8. So it comes out to be 281.25 kilonewton per meter. Again, D greater than BM upon QB. So this time it comes out to be 937.5 mm or say 940 mm. So D required is 940 plus 35. That is cover. So now we have lessened the cover. We can invariably change the cover from 30 mm to 35 mm to 50 mm. That depends on our designing. That does not matter so much. So the D required is 975 mm. As we can see, the D provided was 1000 mm, but required is 975 mm. So D provided is greater than D required. So the section is this time okay. Now, since the section is okay, we'll find the area of steel required. So area of steel is given by the formula B into M divided by sigma ST multiplied by JT. So bending moment was this, we just found out. Sigma ST is this, permissible stress in steel. J value we found earlier and D value we have just found out from here. This is D. Yes, from here. So area of steel comes out to be 1186.47 mm square. So let us assume 20 mm dia bars that we are going to provide. So number of bars is given by AST upon area of one bar. So area of steel divided by area of one bar. This is total area and this is area of one bar. So it comes out to be 3.7. So let us assume it has 4 on the conservative side. So we'll provide 4 bars of 20 mm dia, which gives as actual AST as 1256 mm. Now, step 5, that is check for minimum steel. So this is the formula. AST minimum divided by BD is equal to 0.87 FY. So AST is this much. So it comes out to be 654.24 mm, which should be the minimum provided steel, but this is what we have provided, hence the section is okay. So this is how our section is going to look. This is 975 mm, 35 mm of cover, and this is 940 mm. It is up to here. So it was 400 and this is 4 number bars of 20 mm dia, which we found out. So this was all about today's class. We'll discuss new topics and few more interesting things in next lecture. Till then, all you take care and have a nice time. Thank you. I hope you guys could understand and correlate the topics taught in today's session. If there is any query or subject matter issue, feel free to mail me at the given email ID. Live discussion sessions could also be used for discussion of doubts. Thank you.